And if I now, and if I now show you the data frame, here you can see there is a new column is added to the data frame, whose value is summation of column W and column Y. Here you can W and Y, you can check it here. And if you want to drop the column, you can drop the column using df.drop. The name of the column df is here, data frame name, and x is equals to 1. X is equals to 1 suggests that this is the column. To drop a column, you have to specify that x is equals to 1. And if you run this cell, you will find that the column is gone. But you find, but if you again run the df, you will find that the column is not yet deleted. The reason is, unless you specify that in place equals to true in the drop method, the column won't get deleted. So here again, I am dropping the new column with in place equals to true. So let's see. Now I am running the data frame, and here you can see the new column is gone. And if you want to delete a row, then you have to just give the index of the row, and x is equals to 0 will tell that the row is, it is a row, and the row is gone. See, the E row is now not here. But if you place in place equals to true, then it will delete from the main data frame also. Okay, so now let me start the data preprocessing part. So see, data preprocessing is a process for preparing the raw data to making suitable for machine learning. Because whenever we find a data frame or data set, it is not always means suitable for machine learning. You have to do certain pre-processing before to feed in to the machine learning model, such as many of the data set will have will contain missing values. Missing values are the values whose data is not provided to us. So machine learning model cannot accept the missing values. So you have to consider those missing values, and you have to fill those missing values, or you have to drop those missing values. So you have to do something with this. And after that, many data frame consist of some strings. So if you if it is a flower data set, and there are strings like rose, tulip, so machine learning model cannot work on the strings, because a machine learning model only understand the numerical data. So you have to encode those strings to form a numerical data, so that a machine learning model can understand those data and train your machine learning model. Also, there are some columns data which are not related to our problem, so we should not feed them model, we should not feed them columns to machine learning model, because it will create noise and our result will get poorer. So we will do all of these things in today's session. So here I am using the, so till now, do you have any doubts?
No, sir.
Okay. So let me continue. Wait for a minute. Okay, so for today's session, we are going to use Titanic dataset. Titanic dataset is the dataset of the ship Titanic on of the passengers of the Titanic, their fare details, their age, whether they are adult or they survived or not. This is the most important. So it is the dataset available at Seabonds. Here you can see in the top that I have imported a library Seabone, which we will see in some time. So a Seabone gives us some demo data sets, and in this demo data sets we have Titanic data set. So we have uploaded this Titanic data set using load data set command of Seabone in the variable Titanic. So let's see this, and you will find this data set. Okay, so this is the data set of on the of the ship of Titanic. Here are the details. There are the P class. There survived. They survived or not? The age of the person who were on that ship. The fare they fare of the trip. The class they belong to: third class, first class. They are men or women, or they are adult or not? On the which deck they were, and they are still alive or not? It is the data set which was provided by Seaborn, and we are going to use the data set for our data preprocessing. So first we will. So this is the command Titanic.shape. Titanic here is a data frame, so you can use this command on any data frame. Okay. So this command shows us the size of the data frame that we are using. So here 891 rows and 15 columns are there in this data set. Titanic means it contains 891 person's details. Okay. And here we have another function, Titanic.info. So you can use these all are pandas functions. So you can use these functions on any data frame. The info function will tell us the information about the data set and its null values. So here you can see there are 0 to 14, these 15 classes, 15 columns are given here. And you can see that how many non-null values are there. Non-null values means values that are present. There are no missing values. So in the survived class, we have 891 non-null values. It is a integer type of values, and the 891 non-null values. And if you this get like alive is a object type, it also has 891 values. Alone is a boolean type. So if you see here, alone is false or true. So true or false, it is considered as a boolean value. So, and here you will find that in the deck column, there are only 203 null value, non-null values. It means there are more than 600 values which are missing. So here you can see this is NaN. So whenever you find NaN in the data frame, that means its full form is not a number, or we can consider it as a missing values. These values are not missing. We cannot fit these values to train a machine learning model. So we have to do something with it. So to have to remove this, so we can remove these null values and work along. Okay. So here is another command. Titanic is our data frame, and dot describe is command. So see, dot describe command shows us the detailed description, calculated values about each section of our data set. So here are survive, P class, age, SIB, SP, parch, fair. These are all numerical values. As you can see, age, fair, and these are all numerical values. So all numerical columns are description is given here. The count of all how many entries are there? What is the mean of the class? What is the standard deviation? What is the minimum of the class? What is the top 25% in the top 75%? So all of the information is given in here. Okay, so this is also a command, and Titanic.head. Head is a command. You can specify a number here. If you want more than 5 rows to show, you just specify a number here and you will find all the rows. Okay. Just hover over it and it will show that the head command takes a number which is an integer and return the first n rows. You have to hover over it and it will give a quick documentation about it. Okay. So our first task of data preprocessing is to handle the missing values. So I'm going to execute this command, Titanic.isNull. So this is null command gives us the Boolean representation of the whole Titanic data set, and it and wherever it finds a null value, it mark it as a true, otherwise false. So as you can see in the first and the second, the zero and second row, the DAC value is true here. And if you see here, the zero and second is NaN. Okay. So now if you want to sum all the missing values, you have to concatenate it with a another function called sum. And if you run this, you will find the details of all the columns. So here you can see that survived has no missing values, p class has no missing values, but edge has 177 missing values. So we have to do that, we have to work on it. Embarked has two missing values, deck has 688 missing values. So we have already seen here above that it has only 203 non-missing values, non-null values. So here 688 values are missing. So we have to work on it. And embarked town also has two missing values. So how we will tackle these missing values? So the first method is we can drop all the rows which has missing values. So this is the pandas function, which drops all the rows which has missing values of in any column. Each if it see a missing value, it will drop it. Okay, so let me run this. See, after running this command, if you see here, there are only 182 rows now, and we have started with 891 rows and 15 columns. So it our data set lost is more 75% of its data, because the deck section is now it is no missing value in the data set, but the data set is reduced to 182 passengers only. So this is not a good command here. So if the null values are less, then we can drop. If only 4 or 10 values are missing, then we can use this. But it is reducing 688 rows from our original data set. So it is not a good command here. So we will see a method two. So what we can do with this? So if we, so let me run this. So as you, as I have already stated that when you use this command, I will show you it. See, the edge here, I'm selecting Titanic dataset, edge column, and running isNull function on it. So I have already showed that what a isNull function does. isNull function returns true whenever it finds a null value. Okay, so here I am running this isNull function on edge Titanic, edge column of Titanic. So here you can see there is true here, and maybe there are more, but they are not showed here. So I have this command I have passed as a query to the Titanic dataset itself. So wherever it finds a true, it will return that series only. So let's see. So you can see that there is a Titanic dataset. This is the query that we have passed to it, and whenever it finds a true, means there is a null value in the edge, it returns our it returns all the rows. So you can see that here 177 rows are here, and in all the rows the edge values are null. So here are total 177 values in which the edge value is missing. So and here again I am selecting the edge column of the data set which I have shown. So what we can do, so there are many type of methods to tackle this, but I am going to show you a very simple method. So we can either we can fill all the missing values with mean of the all non missing values. So we have 177 missing values, okay, and we have total 891 values. So we have more than 600 values that are present in the edge column. Okay, So we take the mean of all these values and fill it to the all missing values. Okay, so if you want to check what is the mean, just take this command and run this. You will find that the age column's mean is 29.699, but age is a number, so we cannot put a floating point number here. So that's why I have used np.floor that you already know from your 12th class. A floor command will reduce it to the least integer. So it will become 29 here. Okay, so all missing values, which, whatever you are seeing here, all missing values will be filled with value 29. So this is one method which we can use. Other methods are, if we can fill all the missing values with median, a median of the series, whole age column, or we can fill all these details with mod of the series. Okay, so there is some problem in one cell, but okay. And the fourth type, if you want, you can fill all the missing values with a specific value which you will enter in the fill NA function. Okay, so here you can see the 888, it was a null. Okay, it is filled with 16 here. It is filled with 28 here when we are using median. It is filled with 29 here when we are using mean. So we have, and now, but I have not used in place equals to true in any of the following. So it is not yet filled with, so null values are not yet filled. So I'm using it here, and we are choosing mean values to fill the null values. So if you again run the titanic.isNull.sum, so you will find that now edge column has no missing values. So all the missing values are filled with mean of the edge column. Okay. Now the rest we have the deck column. The deck column has 688 missing values. So if you, let me run this. So see, it has 688 missing values.
Excuse me, sir.
These are, yes.
Yes, I wanted to ask, sir, what is the cutoff limit after which we'll decide that, okay, so now many of the values are missing, so now we should rather just drop the column rather than filling it with a mean or something like that.
See, there is not a limit, but if your data set is in thousands, okay, if you have data of 10,000 or 10,000 people, and you have missing values of 1,000 only, so it also, you are missing with 10% of the data.
Yeah.
And okay, so 10% of the data, if when you train the model, and if that 10% does not low your accuracy of the model, so you can drop this. But if here you can see that there are 688 missing values, so this is almost 75%. So if I drop all the rows which have null values, my data will reduce to only 25%.
So not the rows, the column. Suppose age 75% of the data of the age column is missing, so we will drop that. Yes. Age column altogether.
No, we should drop that column. If you have some special type of functions that you can use to predict those values, so you can use that. But here you can see in this deck column. Okay, so if you will see, this deck column is a where it is? Huh. Deck column is a string column. Okay, if it is so, I cannot predict a string. Okay. So how can I predict that it is a person is from deck A or deck B or deck C? I don't have any function for that. I don't have any strategy for that. Okay. And also, there are many missing values. So we will drop this column. But in the age column, if you can predict that You can group by there are
or we can do one thing rather that this deck column it's subjective like C E or B anything like that. We can just specify a function here. We can map a filter on this column that all the C's are converted to 3, all the E's are converted to 5. That can be done.
No, we can do that. Yeah. We can do that. But still, it is just a number. See, age itself, it has a significant. Okay. You can from other properties like fair or it is alone or alike, you can somewhat calculate this the value of age. Like you can find 49 age, 24 age, but here it is just a one word value. So I don't think that you will be able to find this.
Okay, sir. Thank you.
Yes. What we are doing that the deck column is a categorical column and it has more than 75% data is missing, and all the missing values with the same deck number will create noise in database. So we will drop this column. So after dropping this column, this will become our head. So the here I have used the drop method. It specified the column number and x is equals to 1. This is most important because if you don't specify x is equals to 1, you will get an error. See, because the by default x is 0. That means it will find that it will find in the row. It will demonstrate this deck as an index, so it won't be able to find that column named deck. So you have to specify the axis. And I'm doing this with in place equals to true, so it will drop the deck column. So here you can see in this Titanic data set, now we don't have any deck column. There may be some if you want to predict the data for deck column, you have to consider all other variables and train a model on them. Then you can predict the deck column values which are missing. Then considering that predicted values, you have to again train a model to predict the values of survive column. So you will learn that all in your coming time. But here I am showing you just simple preprocessing. That's why I am not illustrated that. Okay. So now if I run titanic.isNull.sum. Here you can see here are only four, two in the embarked and two in the embarked town. There are only four missing values. So four missing values, it won't affect much because my data set has 891 values. So I can drop these four values without any hesitation. So here I have dropped these four values. You can, by default, x is equals to 0. And drop NA will drop all the missing values rows. Okay. And in place equals to true will save the changes to the Titanic data set. Now, if I run again, see, there are no missing values here. Okay. And here you can see now our data set size is 889 because we have dropped these four missing values from embark and embark town, and 14 columns because we have dropped a deck column. Okay. So any doubts till here? So, okay, we will take the doubt after the session. So here is the part two of the data processing. See, we as I have already said to you that a machine learning model cannot accept this type of strings like male, third, south, Hampton, Chambord, false. It cannot accept this type of things. So you have to encode these in some values. Okay. And this is a command you can use on any data frame to get the list of all the columns. Here you can see they are all the columns of the Titanic dataset, and you can see from here that which type of which columns are categorical. So I have created a list of all the categorical columns here, and I have passed the list in to this for loop. Okay. And it will print all the unique values that all the in all categorical columns. See, the alive column has two values, unique values, no and yes. The class column has three unique values, third, first, and second. The embarked town has three unique values. Embarked has three unique values. Sex has two unique values. Who has three unique values? So if you have finite number of unique values, you can encode that. But if you have infinite number of unique values, you should drop that column. Like if you have ID column, ID for all the passengers will be different. And it will let us assume that it will start from one. So here we have 891 columns. So the ID for the last passenger will be 891. And it is just indicating the person's ID. But when you try to train the model without dropping that column, the model will think that this is a number which is important for the last man and less important for the first man, because the first person has the value 1 and the last person has value 891. So this type of columns we should drop. Okay, so here we don't have any columns like that, and also we have all these categorical columns have finite number of unique values. So I have used a command here. See, Titanic, the name of the category which from the categorical columns one by one, alive, class, embarked, town, embarked, and the unique function. Unique function is the function which tells in the series how many types of unique values it has. See, if I run Titanic, who, if I run Titanic who, it will return the column who, and if I run unique, will return the unique values that this column has. So it has three unique values: man, woman, and child. Okay, and there is one more command. Wait, I will. See, there is one more command: nUnique. nUnique gives the number of unique values. Okay. So it is just it just calculate the number of elements in this array and show the unique values in a particular series. So what we should do now? So as you can see, if you see here that the who column has three unique values: man, woman, and child. So what we should what we have to do? We have to create its dummy variables, or you can you can tell this as a label encoding. Okay, so there are this is the data our data for 889 people, and I passed this Titanic who column to the PD is the short form of pandas we have imported, and this is the function get dummies function encodes that value to the particular column itself. Okay, so wait for a minute. If you will see that the first column has man as a value, so for the first column, main column shows 1. Second has woman as a value of second row has woman as a value, so woman shows 1. And in this type the it encodes all the data and give us the columns. So this is just for one column, and we have to do this for all the categorical columns. So we can pass the data parameter here. Okay, you can see if you anytime you have you want to know how this works, you just have to pass its name and question mark and run the cell. You will find all the full signature and docstring parameters, all of the things you will find here, okay, in the docstring. See, it takes a data parameter. So I specified the data is the Titanic data. It takes the columns parameter. The columns parameter takes the list of the columns, all the columns that I wanted to encode. So all these categorical columns I want to encode. So I have passed the categorical columns as a value to the columns, and now I will run this cell. Okay. So now you can see now our data set has 889 rows and 26 columns, because as you can see here, alive is partitioned into two new columns, alive no and alive yes. As you can see, alive no for the first one, yes for the second one. So here alive no is labeled as one for the first person, and yes is labeled as one for the second person. Here we have three classes, third, first, and second class. So for the first person, it is third class. So class third is labeled as one, class first and second is labeled as zero. For the second, it is first class. So first is labeled as one, all others are zeros. So in this way, it encodes all the categorical columns, and it creates separate columns for all of the unique values that a column has. Okay. So now you have to save this. So again, I am saving this new data frame to the Titanic variable itself. Okay, so if you run the Titanic, you will find that it is now the new data set is came here with 889 rows and 26 columns. So here also we have a method here, Titan. It is a data frame dot to CSV. This method creates a CSV file of CSV file. CSV file is a comma separated file. Okay, comma separated file. You can open this file in Microsoft Excel or Google Sheets. There is no problem. So you can save this file as a CSV file using this command, titanic.2csv, the name of the CSV. And here I have stated that index equals to false. If I don't say index equals to false, it will create one more column named index, and it will save this value 0, 1, 2, 8, 890 in the index column. So I don't want that. That's why I have labeled here index equals to false. So let me run this. See, after running this, you will find here that a new file is created, new titanic.csv. You can download this file from here, and it is now available at your system. So can you see my Excel screen? I think it is not visible. Anyone?
Excel.
Which screen?
Excel screen is not visible, sir.
Okay, wait for a minute. Now it is visible?
Yes, it's visible now.
So it is a new titanic.csv file that we have downloaded now, and it looks like this. It has all the data separated by comma, as you can see here. This all the data is separated by commas, and in the first row we have name of all the columns. Okay, so this is all about data preprocessing. Now we will start from data visualization. Okay, my screen is visible, right?
Yes, sir.
Okay. So wait for a minute. I'm going to collapse this. Okay. So data visualization. So data visualization is the presentation of data in form of graph, charts, or other visual formats. We do this to understand our data and to do some analysis on that, and to drop unwanted columns, to normalize it, and all these things we do after visualize our data. So here we are going to use TIPS dataset. It is also presented by Seaborn. Okay. So wait for a minute. I'll okay. So this is our TIPS dataset. It is a dataset in which the bill of a customer is present, the tip he or she has given, the gender, he's a smoker or not, the day at which he came to the hotel, at the time, and the size of the person. Someone's microphone is on. Who is this? Please turn off your microphone. Okay. So this is the size of our data set. We have 244 rows and 7 columns. These are the 7 columns that we have, and we are going to use Matplotlib and Seaborn, these two libraries, for our data visualization. Wait, I will tell you about Matplotlib. So this is the Matplotlib website. It is an open source library which you can fork on GitHub if you want to contribute to it. And here are some contribution guidelines you should follow before contributing. So you can find the various type of plots that you can create using Matplotlib. Line plots, multiple subplots. You can also plot some images, histogram plots, path plots, three-dimensional plotting. So it has more than 50 type of plots that you can create. I will be showing you the most simpler 2 or 3 plots. Okay. So here as you can see, we have this is a scatter plot which creates a point for every x and y axis. So here x axis I have stated as total bill. So x axis shows the total bill of all the customers, and y axis shows the tip of all the customers. Okay, So as you can see here, as the bill amount is increasing, tip amount is also increasing. So it makes sense. It is it has some linearity. So it is a scatter plot. You have to use TLT. I have included here. See, as you can see, matplotlib.pyplot. We are using matplotlib.pyplot as PLT here. Okay. So all plots we are covering is under matplotlib.pyplot. Okay. So here is the first plot. This is a scatter plot which creates a point whenever these two values are finding. Okay. So this is the first plot, scatter plot, and its syntax you can see by quick documentation. This is the all syntax, the parameters, or you can also use help function, which I have already showed you how to do this. It has more than 20 parameters, but all are not essential. You have to pass at least two parameters for scatter plot, x-axis and y-axis. So this column we are passing as x-axis, and this column we are passing as y-axis. Okay, and this is a line plot. A line plot takes only one argument, so we are passing only total bill as a line plot. Okay, so it is showing us here is the number of people we have, 244 people. So it is for 244 people, and all the total bill. It creates a line by joining all the total bills. Okay. Also plt.hist, it also takes one argument. It creates a histogram. Histogram means we have it is creating a normal distribution in the range, like total bill in the range of 10 to 20. There are more than almost 65 people who have their bill in the range of 10 to 20. There are almost 30 people who have their bill in range of 20 to 30. So you can get this information from the histogram plot. Okay. So now I'm going to show you the distribution plots. So I will show you about the Seaborn. Seaborn is another library for the data visualization, and it is built on the top of Matplotlib. But the advantage is this, that Seaborn works better and it has more functionality than matplotlib.pyplot. It also consists many type of plots, many colorful plots. See, like this, you can check this website, seaborn.pydata.org, to see all of this. Okay. And these are some box plots, violin plots. These are some line plots. These are some bar plots. It has more than 30 types of different types of plots. We are going to cover six of them. Okay. So these are some settings I'm doing for my presentation purpose. We don't need to know about it now. So first plot is distribution plots. As you have seen the histogram plot here, which we create, which shows the total number of here it is showing that the number of people who has bill among in this range. Okay, same this plot will show the same, but with some better visualization. Okay, so here you can see in the x-axis we have total bill, and the y-axis we have count. So in the range of 20, at the range of 0 to 20, the many people have their bill, almost 50 people have their bill in the range of 0 to 20. You can understand this, and you can search for this plot and you will get all the information on the Google also. Okay, so the second one is joint plot. So the joint plot is somewhat similar as scatter plot, but it compares the two histograms, means two these plots are joined side by side. See, here you can see that this is also a scatter plot in between, and here it is showing the density, means it's the tip in the range of 2 to 4 how many people have the tips here. So more the dense area it is, it will create a bigger line for that. Okay, so this is a joint plot. You can get information from the joint plot, and it has five type of kinds. Like the first one is, it is scatter plot, which shows scattered points. The second, it has a hex plot. Hex plot to it also takes a parameter x, y, and the data. If we have stated all the data here, so the parameters will be our columns. Okay, and the kind will show us which type of, which kind we want our plot. So here you can see this part is the most darker part, because this part has most more density than other parts. More the dense area it is, it will create the more darker part for that. Okay, so this is joint plot. Also, you can there is a parameter hue. Hue is a parameter which you can use to you can pass any categorical column, and it will split your plot on the basis of that categorical column. So here you can see this, the all the orange points are for the people who are not smoker. All the blue points are for the people who are smoker. And here you can see their distribution plots also. And this S parameter is for the size of points. If I increase this, the size of points will increase. See, okay. So there, the third plot we have, pair plot. Pair plot is a plot which creates all the type of plot, possible plots in the set. So you just have to provide a data set here, a data frame here, and it will create all the possible type of plots. See, this plot is for total wheel to total wheel, this for total wheel to tip, this for total wheel to size. Size is a numerical number in this data frame. That's why there are too many straight lines here. Okay, this we have just created tip to total wheel. This is the reverse of it, total wheel to tip. So as the tip is increasing, total wheel is increasing. Here you can see these points are relating that the higher the tip, higher the total wheel here. Okay, and this size versus size, this plot says that, see, if you will see that there are 156. Okay, so this is another pandas command which you can use on any series. You just have to pass a series, and after that use value counts. It will count all the number of unique values and its occurrences. Okay, so in the size column you have 156 values as 2, 38 values as 3, 37 values as 4, and here you can see the same. Okay, so between the wait for a minute. Okay, so this size with a size chart also shows the same. Okay, it will just count the occurrences of the unique values and it shows a bar plot for that. And there are also, if you want to increase the size of pair plot, you have to pass this aspect and height as a parameter, and it will increase the size of your pair plot. Okay, like this is so small to see. So if you want to increase the size, you just pass these parameters, aspect and height. It will increase the size of each plot. And hue here is to separate the data on. Here I have passed sex to split it over gender. Okay, so here the legends are given here. All the blue points refers to the male, and all the orange points refers to the female. Okay, and this plot underscore kws, it is for increasing the size of points. Okay, so Now we will see the categorical plots. These are all distribution plots. We can we are using distribution plots. That means TP is also numerical data. Total bill is also numerical data. Okay. Now how we will visualize the data which is not categorical, which is not numerical. That means categorical data. So I have given a small introduction of all of this in the notebook. You can refer to that. Okay. So this is a bar plot. Bar plot means here I have applied x equals to the gender column and y equals to the total bill column. So here as you can see, the x is a categorical column. It has two categories, male and female, and y is not a categorical column. It is a numerical column. So what this bar plot shows to us that for male, what is the total bill? Bar plot shows the mean of the bill. Okay, so for all the men's, the total mean of the total bill is around 20. Okay, for the female, the mean of the total bill is around 17. Okay, so this you can so this information you can get from bar plot. Also, if you want that bar plot to show the standard deviation instead of mean or a variance instead of mean, you just have to pass a function, pass a argument estimator. Estimator is an argument, and you have to pass your own function. So here I am using NumPy's standard deviation function. So now this the same plot will now show us the standard deviation as the peak of the all bar. Okay. So here now you can see the standard deviation of total bill according to the male is around between 8 to 10, and for the female it is almost 8. Okay, so you can also use np dot mean, or there are different type of function. Np you can also use np dot mean, np dot median, all other function. It will act accordingly. Also, you can use a hue parameter. Hue parameter I have already showed you. It will split your data on the given column name. So here you can see if I have passed the parameter hue of column smoker. So now this the plot shows us the males in the blue which smokes, and in the orange that do not smokes. Okay, so the male who the male, all of the male who smokes, their standard deviation is almost 10. And who don't smoke, their standard deviation is around 8 to 9, and same for the female. Okay, so now we are going to see another plot. This is a count plot. This is a simple plot. It generally count the occurrences of all the data. So I have applied here x here shows the smoker column from our TIFF data set. And data is tips. So there are almost 100 people who are smoker, and more than 140 people who are not smoker. It is just a counting of count plot. Just count the number of occurrences of different unique values. So the smoker class is two unique values, yes and no. So it counts the occurrence of yes, and after that it counts the occurrence of no. Okay, and in the matplotlib and seaborn, as I have already said, that seaborn is built on the top of matplotlib. So you can customize seaborn plots using matplotlib. So here I am using a function plt.figure, and I am passing a variable argument fixSize. fixSize is a argument which is used to increase or decrease the size of our figure. Okay, so I have 12.6 I have passed here. So now my as you can see, my plot is now a bit bigger, and I have also passed the hue parameter here. Now you can see the smoker and male smokers are around 60, and female smokers are around 40, and the male who do not smokes are around 100, and the female who do not smokes are around 60. So we have partitioned it using hue parameter. Okay. Again, there is one more plot I am going to show. This is a strip plot. Strip plot also shows the occurrences. See here, here X is the day, on Thursday, Friday, Saturday, Sunday, and Y is the total bill. So here it is showing that on the Thursday, and how many total bills were generated on Thursday. So some bills are around 10, some bills are around 50 on Friday. You can see that on Friday there are less number of total bills. That means the sale was not as good on Friday as on other day. Here most dense part is Sunday, so sale is very good on Sunday. On Sunday there was a more dense graph we are getting. So it is around $50 or units, whatever it is the most expensive bill on that day. Okay, it is the strip plot shows this, and also you can use a hue in this. See, so now again this is the same plot, but now it shows the people who are smoker and the people who are not the smokers. So some smokers are paying very high here, and you can analyze this. Like on Friday there are only two or three smokers were there. So these are the different kind of things you can analyze using data visualization. There are many more kinds. There are almost 20 to 50 types of different plots which demonstrate you different kinds of information. But this is all for today. So if you have any queries, we can answer that, or we can end now. So anyone have queries?